DeLissio, thank you for this opportunity, first of all, to provide input into the upcoming budget talks being held in Harrisburg. I'm here to ask for full restoration of the general assistance category of MA and full funding of programs included in the proposed block grant. A cut as large as 10% for social services in the state of Pennsylvania proposed by Governor Corbett will cause many of the people that you support and serve to simply lose out. This is why full funding of social services is so important. I agree with Representative Jean DiGirolamo, I'm sorry for not pronouncing his name appropriately, but who recently told the Patriot News that if the cuts in block grants go forward, thousands of people will be turned away from housing, food, and treatment. As a provider of behavioral health and child welfare services in the city of Philadelphia and surrounding counties, we serve approximately 3,000 children and families throughout a given year. It is no surprise that I have seen firsthand the devastation that has occurred to the family unit. These families turn to agencies like Northern Home for Children during these difficult times. Without this funding, they will not receive the mental health and housing services they need. The consequences is that their needs will not go away, but rather shifted to another system that is less cost-effective and ill-equipped to deal with the breadth of their issues. For example, our Generations One program is a residential program for teenage mothers and their babies funded in part by CBH and DPW. Without this program, these young ladies and their child will not receive the care they so desperately need. And even worse, consequences that their child would be a dire risk of repeating this vicious cycle. Simply put, this program impacts generations of families and interrupts the needs for continued systematic support. However, under Governor Corbett's block grant plan, there's a chance Northern Home will lose this opportunity to serve this population. Concurrently, our school therapeutic services program supports children and their families with treatment care designed to evaluate their psychological, emotional, and socioeconomic needs. We meet them where they are in order to provide this care. Without funding for these services, the students may still attend schools, but they would do so in jeopardy because their behavioral health and child welfare needs would not be met, as well as other students could be compromised. In the afternoons and evenings all across the city of Philadelphia, there are consumers who have no place to go. Instead, they're involved in after-school programs, such as our after-school initiative at Northern Home and our partial hospitalization program, where we provide a healthy meal, educational tutoring, psychiatric support, recreational services, all geared towards educating the children and their families about healthy choices. This work cannot be done alone. It must be done in collaboration with legislature. As a result, I request that you represent Northern Home for Children and the families that we serve when you return to Harrisburg to educate Governor Corbett as to the negative impacts of his proposed budget cuts. I am confident that you, as well as your peers, will articulate this message to continue to promote behavioral health, child welfare services, not only within the city of Philadelphia and surrounding counties, but the state as a whole. What better example could we be than to show the other states in the union that we will not tolerate being driven into action that will hurt our citizens, especially those who are most vulnerable? I respectfully submit this, Tracey Lavallias from Northern Home for Children.